Hey guys, welcome back to another movie review. It's been a little while since I've recorded, but I'm excited to be back, and today we're going to be talking about A Serious Man. A Serious Man came out in 2009, and it's directed and written by the Coen brothers. It stars Michael Stuhlbarg, Sari Lennick, Richard Kind, and Fred Melamed. The film is about a Jewish physics teacher in 1967 Minnesota who is going through this existential, religious, and personal crises as bizarre and unfortunate circumstances start to kind of take place all around him. Our main character is Larry, and he's played by Michael Stuhlbarg, and he just wants to be a serious man. The Coen brothers, as well as myself, are both from the great state of Minnesota.
Oh, you betcha, yeah.
So obviously, I do have a little bit of a special place for them in my heart. Other films that you would probably recognize them from would be The Big Lebowski, No Country for Old Men, as well as the classic Minnesota tale, Fargo. Like Fargo, this film is shot and based in Minnesota and is very much a Minnesota story. The big difference, though, is going to be that Fargo is going to be a little bit darker film and focuses more on those Minnesota mannerisms and ways of life in order to make fun of them.
Yeah.
Whereas here, we see a shift of that emphasis to the Jewish communities that exist in Minnesota as the Coen brothers were raised Jewish. This feels like a very intimate project for them, and very possibly like they could have thought of just a bunch of anecdotes from their childhood and used all of those to craft this fictional tale. After reading a little bit on the old Wikipedia, it seems as though that some of this inspiration came directly from a rabbi from their childhood. The movie opens with this fictional Jewish folk tale that they write out that allegedly has absolutely nothing to do with the rest of the movie, other than the fact that it is Jewish and comedic, but it really does set the stage perfectly for what is about to come. This film is darkly comedic and hilarious from the get-go, and I can only imagine that if you were raised in a similar Jewish household or community, that it probably hits even harder, but I don't honestly think that it's necessary to be Jewish or have been raised Jewish to really enjoy this movie. It opens up with us hearing, in the dark, somebody to love. It is blasting, and then we... Oh yeah, you betcha, eh? There's some thunderstorms out here, okay? As I was going to say, the film opens up with us inside of the ear of Larry's son, and we hear blasting and blaring, somebody to love. Somebody to love! And we start to realize that, yeah, we are in the ear of his son, and what's happening is he's actually listening on some sort of personal cassette player to that song while he's in class, whereas at the same time, Larry's actually at the doctor's office, and it really just starts to set the stage for all of the comedy and the irony that is going to come, especially when the doctor actually offers Larry a cigarette, really allowing us to feel that, okay, we have been transported now to the 1960s. Michael Stuhlbarg, as Larry, is utterly perfect in this role as an insecure father, insecure husband, and an insecure man who is going through this crisis of faith. There is so much absurdity in this movie that happens from a Korean student who tries to bribe our protagonist in order to get a better grade, all the way to his wife wanting to get a religious divorce called a get in order to be able to marry the widowed Cy Abelman, who is perfectly played. So what does Larry do in response to all of this? Larry goes and visits various rabbis. He wants to visit kind of the mid-level main rabbi right away, but instead he ends up seeing the junior rabbi who decides to compare kind of God's presence to everyday things. And what he ends up doing is using a parking lot as an example, and it's a gut-busting and hilarious sequence.
God's will, you don't have to like it, of course.
The boss isn't always right, but he's always the boss.
That's right! Things aren't so bad. Look at the parking lot, Larry!
This film is perfectly set, so when it comes to production design, as well as the location scouting, it's very well done, and it feels very much so like a St. Louis Park a Jewish neighborhood. That's where the Coen brothers grew up. And they wanted to find something that really fit that kind of vibe, that made them feel like, okay, this is what it looked like when we were kids in our neighborhood in St. Louis Park. This film is beautiful and it's beautifully shot. And why is that? Why is that? Oh yeah, you betcha. That's because it's Roger Deakins behind the camera. Once again, teaming up with the Coen brothers here, a longtime collaborator of theirs on other movies like Fargo, The Big Lebowski, True Grit, and I also believe No Country for Old Men. All of these characters are perfect. They're very lived in and real in their own way, but also very much so Coen brothers characters. And with that, there's a certain level of peculiarity to these characters that we get from the old rabbi that congratulates the new kids who recently have had their bar mitzvah and kind of reached the end of their religious education, to Arthur, which is the brother of our main protagonist character, Larry, as well as the neighboring Goy, who is a non-Jewish neighbor who clearly doesn't have a very good relationship with Larry. The film is very funny, but it isn't just pure comedy. It is also a drama that brings up deeper questions of faith and purpose, asking the big questions like, why do bad things happen? Does God exist? Why does God let these things happen? And then what is my purpose in all of this? These are just some of the questions that we see Larry, our protagonist, ask internally with his performance, as well as externally to the rabbis, and that we are actually allowed to ask ourselves and contemplate as we kind of observe Larry's misfortunes. This film is an absolute gem. It is endlessly rewatchable. It actually gives me similar vibes to The Big Lebowski, but I would say it's more dramatic and it delves deeper into the mind of our main protagonist. I loved this movie, and honestly, if you're a Coen Brothers fan and you haven't seen this movie, what are you doing? Go find it right away. And even if you aren't necessarily a Coen Brothers fan, I still highly recommend it. You should go find it, go check it out. It is a great time. Without further ado, I'm gonna give this movie, A Serious Man, a 10 out of 10. Woo! You betcha, everybody. Minnesota coming in for the win. Woo! Thank you guys so much for watching. Go ahead, let me know in the comments below, what is your favorite Coen Brothers movie? Or if you've seen A Serious Man, let me know what you think about it. Once again, hit like, subscribe, let me know what you think about my videos. I really appreciate it. And as always, I will see you guys in the next review.